Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics 1. This lecture is entitled Combinational Logic Parallel Binary Adders. Okay, if you remember from our previous lecture, we discussed basic binary arithmetic addition. We use that to develop the expression for the sum and the carry bit. We use that to define this little device called the half adder. Okay, if you remember it, a half adder looks like this, where the sum bit is A exclusive OR B, and carry out is A and B. If I wanted to do the full minimized SOP expression without that funny exclusive OR symbol, it's going to look like that. What I did, I put it in a box, and I called that a half adder. And then I took that half adder and created a new component called a full adder. And a full adder externally looks like this. And that's called a full adder, that symbol right there. I know there's a sum output, but that symbol right there is for adders. How does a full adder look like internally? Well, there's several definitions we came up with. We came up with a minimum SOP expression for the sum bit and the carry out. Those look like this. And those were the fully minimized SOP expressions. And then we realized, hey, we could potentially come up with an alternate explanation for these things using potentially a sub-optimized expression for CO, which makes use of a half adder. And what that looks like is this. And the written expression for that is A and B, or CI and with A exclusive OR B. And additionally, we realize that the sum expression, all that really means right there is when it's odd. What I can use is some of the associative properties of exclusive OR gates, exclusive OR AB, exclusive OR with CI should produce the same output for my sum. And then from there, we went on to show that I can take this expression and this expression and use our previous definition of a half adder to put two half adders with an accessory component to perform the function of a full adder. We went ahead and hooked that up, and it looks like this. Okay, and without the guts, that's how the two half adders are hooked up, this being respectfully the A half, B half, sum half, C out half for both those half adders. And notice too, I've given you the SOP expression for both the carry out and the sum. What I'm doing here below it is what we're trying to implement using the combined half adders. With the guts, we should be implementing the expressions in yellow. Let's draw the guts inside there for each one of the half adders. Okay, with the guts, they look like that. Let's go ahead and do the easiest one. Let's do the sum first. I'm gonna get rid of some of these green lines here. We're doing the sum expression first. So it looks like it's A exclusive OR B. A exclusive OR B, in turn, exclusive OR CI. That's our sum bit. Okay, let's go ahead and wipe out those directional indicators. Let's do the CO. Okay, so the CO circuit, we're looking for CI ANDed. Here's our CI ANDed, and that output, whatever it's being ANDed with, is being fed to an OR. What is it ANDing? Well, exclusive OR A, exclusive OR B, exclusive OR A, exclusive OR B. There you go. What is it being ORed with? A and B, A and B. So we've just showed how we can use these two half adders in combination to come up with a full adder. We had minor accessory component with an OR gate. Okay, that was a review. Another portion of the review is how does a full adder work? What's the truth table? You should be able to spit this out. This is for a review from the last time. We used it to come up with these expressions right here. Okay, there's all possible combinations of input. What is my output based upon these input conditions? Well, when you're adding three zeros together, you should get a zero as an output. If I'm adding 1, 1 together, I should get a 1, 2 binary equivalent, a 1, 2, whoops, expand that definition, 2. And finally, all three of them, you should get a 3. So what do I get here? This is 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. What does this CO imply? Potentially feeding out to another stage. Where would I feed it? Maybe to another's CI. Let's look at the little joke I've drawn up here, parallel binary adders. Get it? If that didn't hit you like a club, man. Look at each one's output. It's feeding the next one's inputs. What is the functional model for our adder? It's got three inputs, A, B, and CI, and two outputs, sum and carry out. What if I put another one right next to it? It would almost be like that longhand addition where I've got A1, the MSB, A0, the LSB, B1, B0. So if I was to add A0 and B0, I would produce a sum 0, and it would produce a carry out. What is that carry out? It's that one's carry in. What is the addition of A1 and B1? Someone. What does that one produce? Its carry out. What am I going to call it, for lack of a better term? Sum 2, i.e. the MSB of my output. How would I hook this thing up? And pay attention that the lower order adder has a carry in input. Okay, there you have to do something with it. Okay, the easiest connection is obviously this one. Due to my long form addition. That one's carry out is the next one's carry in. So if I define this as my low, this is my higher, not highest order, because you'll see what we're going to do in a second. This one's carry out feeds that one's carry in. What are my input bits? I'm adding the LSBs of both numbers. I'm adding the MSBs of both numbers. What am I getting out? There's some LSB next in our series, whoops, and finally our carry out is our MSB out. There's my LSB. The question remains, there is an unused input, which we have not, or not unused, an incorrectly hooked up input, namely this guy. What is the lowest order's carry in? The answer is 0. It's the lowest order. What do I do with it? Tie it to ground. Too easy. We just made a 2-bit parallel binary adder. Why is it called in parallel? Because A1 comes in and A0. It's a 2-bit number. B1 and B0 comes in. It's a binary number. Let me go ahead and clean up the top so I can make this diagram. A1 and A0 respectfully split, and B1 and B0 respectfully split into their parallel paths. You have to do this. That's LSB. That's MSB. LSB, MSB. Where do the higher orders, i.e. the MSBs, go? Do they go to the lower or the higher order? Obviously, they go to the higher order adder. Where do the LSBs go? They go to the lower order adder. They're splitting up into these parallel paths. Let's see if I can draw that a little bit prettier. There you go. A1 and B1 respectively being the MSBs of their particular number being routed to the higher order adder, and A0 and B0 being respectfully routed to the lower order adder. Okay, so that was a 2-bit adder. Why not make a 3-bit adder? What do you think it's going to look like? Obviously, it's going to require 3 adders. The carry out of one stage feeds the carry in of the next stage. The carry out of the second stage feeds that of the third stage. What is my lower order carry in? It's a 0. It's a ground. Where do I respectfully route B0, B1, B2? Respectfully, the LSB to MSB. And then where do I route A2, A1, A0? Respectfully, be the MSB to LSB. Should look something like this. There's the B's in blue, and there's the A's in red. Most importantly, where's my output? If I'm adding the two LSBs right here, what do you think I'm going to get as my output right here? That's my sum LSB. There's the next highest one. There's my next highest one. I could call this carry out for that final stage, but since it's the number that I'm looking for, that's the final most significant bit. There's my MSB to my LSB of my sum. Go ahead and just put in some input combinations to this. Okay, let's try. A is 3. B is 5. What's my output going to be? It's going to be 8. So if you've done something wrong, it's not going to be 8. Take it stage by stage. For the blue, the B's, put 101, 5 on it. 1, 0, 1. For the red, the A's, put 0, 1, 1. What's the output of each stage? Sticking with a lower order MSB, a 1 and a 1 should produce a 1, 0. Respectfully, 1, 0. So that is my sum bit. That carry out bit goes to this guy. It's rippling forward. Okay, hence the name ripple adder, too, sometimes used. Okay, finally, A and B, we're talking about the middle adder now, has 1 and 0, and we got a carry in of 1. So my carry out should be 1, my sum should be 0. So that's carried down. This is rippled forward for a 1 input there. 0 plus 1 is 1, plus 1 more is 1, 0. Oh my gosh, my answer is MSB to LSB, 8, just like we'd expect. Try this out with other combinations and get that idea of using the parallel inputs and outputs. So here's a great game to play. Got a bunch of boxes here. I've got inputs, A2, A1, A0, 101. Inputs, B2, B1, B0, 100. I want to know the outputs, and I want you to put them in the green boxes here. That's sum 3, 2, 1, and 0. And additionally, what I want to know is the carry-ins for the low stage, the middle stage, and the high stage. Okay, if you've done everything correctly, your work should look like this. Okay, so there's my A's, there's my B's, there's the carry-in for my low order. I tied it to ground. It's a 0. Okay, so now based upon the inputs, 1, 0, 0 on that low order adder, what is the sum 0 and the carry in for the medium stage? Should look like this. There you go. What is the output for the sum and the carry out for the middle stage? And respectfully, what is the carry in for the high order? Now finally, the high order has A input 1, B input 1. Its CI, its carry in, is 0. What are the outputs carry out and sum? There you go. And all this stuff here and here should look like this. There you go. And again, it's the answer you'd expect. 5 plus 4 is 9. Okay, if you get something different, you've done it wrong. One quick aside here. I'm using this reusable component, the full adder, which if you remember right, we made of two half adders. I could just as easily come up with the SOP expression for the whole thing. I wanted to make full adder. 6 inputs, A2, A1, A0, B2, B1, B0. Actually, 7 inputs because I do have the its carry in. And what am I going to put as its outputs? It's going to have sum 0, sum 1, sum 2, and its carry out. So 7 ins, 4 outs. I could just as easily make a 7 variable KMAP and do it 4 times for all those outputs. Okay, I used to know how to do a 7 variable KMAP. I would be very, very hard pressed to do that right now. Point of the matter is use a component you've already created. Okay, using a functional block of a full adder, which you already created, and you did the KMAP analysis for a single half adder, and then you single full adder, and then all you do is just reuse that full adder over again. So this is kind of a tricky technique here, the structural approach of using reusable components over and over again. I don't have to do a KMAP analysis for 7 inputs. Did a KMAP analysis for 3 inputs, and it worked just fine. And then I'm just taking that 3 input device and using it 1 time, 2 times, 3 times. Which leads us to the next question. How am I going to make a 4-bit parallel adder? And if you don't know how to do this by now, again, it's like you got to be actively involved with this thing. How do I make a 4-bit parallel adder? Exactly the same way I did a 3 adder. Put another one to the left of it. Take the carry out of the one previously. Feed it to the higher order carry in. It's going to look like this. There you go. Take 4 adders. Put them next to each other. Take my lowest order. Make sure its carry in is 0. Take that lowest order adder. Its output C out. Feed it to the next higher order C in. And do that for this one. And do that for that one. How do I route my inputs? If I've got a 4-bit number A coming in, A3, A2, A1, A0, and I want to add it with this 4-bit number, B3, B2, B1, B0. Do this. Put the Bs, MSB to LSB, and the respectful high to low order stages. Do the same thing for the As. Okay, where do I get my outputs? From the lower order stage, I'm getting my LSB for my sum, and then I'm working my way up. Whoops. Where is my MSB? Right there. So for the examples I had showed previously, 3 plus 5, they were 3-bit numbers, 0. And I'm talking about those previous examples I gave you. 3 plus 5, they're both 3-bit numbers. What was my answer? It was a 4-bit number. So I've got to have that MSB has got to allow for room for overflow. Because a 3-bit number, imagine adding 7 and 7. There's going to be an overflow because we need to go to the next bit position to represent 14. Okay, so that's why this is the MSB, not that one. And now the next question is how do I make an 8-bit adder? And you might groan. You might say, okay, you mean to tell me you're going to make me draw this whole thing over 8 times? And the answer is no. Make this thing a component. Make a 4-bit adder out of this guy. See what I'm doing here is I'm using reusable components over and over and over again. What are my inputs for a 4-bit adder? Well, it's this thing, that thing, and this carry in. So make a block diagram. So we've come up with a 4-bit adder now. What's inside the 4-bit adder? All this stuff right here. And the only thing I've really done here is I've changed that sum 4 to a carry out. You see that right there? Now what if I want to do is create an 8-bit binary adder, take 2 4-bits and hook them together in the exact same fashion we did this guy. Okay, so there's 2 4-bit adders. I'm going to tie this carry in to ground since it's the lowest order. Take this one's carry out, feed it to that one's carry in, How am I going to define where B7 through 0 go and A7 through 0 go? There you go. And now where is my outputs? Right here. MSB to LSB. How many bit positions is it? It's 9. And I'm going to call that sum 8 through 0. And be aware, some manufacturers, for whatever reason, they always start 1 there. So that would be 9 there. I don't understand why, you know, again, when in Rome, do what the Romans do. Just be aware that my numeration for those subscripts may be different between manufacturers. How would I do this for 16 bits? Hook up 4 of them, or I could just as easily, again, structural approach, take 2 4-bit adders, use them as components, call it 8-bit adder. This is a kind of exhausted this discussion of parallel binary adders, but again, serves to reinforce what we're going to be doing with VHDL a little bit later, is building a module, testing a module, take that module, build a larger module, test that module, take that module in combination with others of its type, test that module, build a module, test a module, build a module, test a module. Ultimately, we can come up with an 8-bit adder. We can come up with a 16-bit adder, and so on and so forth. We will come back to these things a little bit later because we could potentially use this thing for subtractors. There are also predefined components within VHDL that we can make use of. Okay, this concludes this portion of the lecture, the parallel binary adders.